this piece of basswood into a horse, a stallion, I believe. I might go for stallion. So, what I often first do is look at the wood. Listen to its resonance. Yes. I'm zoning in on its resonance frequency. Okay. What I'm seeing when looking at this particular piece is the mane of the horse, approximately in this sector, and of course the nose, or I believe on a horse it's called a snout, right about there, and then we will bring down its frontal quadrant here, its back here, and the tail region here. Of course, this isn't a full-size figure. We do have time constraints to complete. And when we finish, I will then provide this horse with its very own leather saddle. So that means all this material must be removed, unless we want a Lego horse, which I have been known to carve a beautiful Lego horse. I shall begin the carving process. See, my carving knife is sharpened to the specifications of the laser beam edge. Laser edge, they call it. Yes, I believe that's looking just like a horse. Let's keep going. Get some big chips on. his head. It'd come like this, and its ears would be here, and its mane, which means this has to go. This is the horse's snout, his beak. It's a horse beak. And then chest down to his legs. You learn all. ears will be here and here. So we must taper this down to the tip of his snout. Settlers and cowboys alike to use as transport, for its utilitarian value. I'm now rounding off the snout, giving it more. Some have said, when I get my hands on a carving knife and a good piece of wood, I am virtually like a human 3D printer. Snout. A horse's snout is its most valuable asset. It is perfectly shaped so that a horse may take down its prey. The horse's snout allows it to have extended reach. So when pursuing prey, the extended snout allows extra reach for tackling prey to the ground. Now I believe from my equestrian roots, when a tackles its prey to the ground. It functions much like your common tiger or lion. Once the horse has the prey tackled to the ground, I believe it uses its snout to smother the animal. Sometimes, using its hooves as battering rams or like clubs. You know, its hooves. Look at that animal. Dangerous. Majestic, but dangerous. A horse's teeth are highly adaptable. They can process everything. Wheat and barley to chicken, moose, and its favorite prey, the North American deer. It's a very versatile creature. I believe I can fly, and I believe I can touch the sky. I literally don't know the next verse. That's it. That's all I know. Okay. I think there is no question that this horse is so lifelike, you'd almost believe it could run off. But if I were to let such a creature run free in my neighborhood, it would almost certainly take down the neighbor's German Shepherd. Possibly, it would eat a beagle like a little M&M. Horses eat beagles like M&Ms. Yes. So these are the hooves. These hooves. You can see where it gets its great strength. Great strength. Speaking of great strength. Shape.